Stars.
Welcome back for my latest video for bloodydisgusting.com. As with my last tutorial, which was for an alien facehugger, which if you have not seen, what are you doing? Go watch it. This is a makeup that I did a long while ago for Instagram, actually for a collab, I think. And as with the facehugger, it's something I've wanted to do a tutorial for ever since. So with that being said, here's how I made myself into Nemesis from Resident Evil. As always, the first thing I do is make the teeth, and I'm using a white air drying clay. I break off a small chunk at a time, keeping the rest wrapped up in the packet so that it doesn't dry out, and I start to shape it with my fingers. I dip my finger in water every now and again to help shape and smooth out the clay, and I also use a spatula to more accurately shape the tip of the teeth. I'm gonna make the face structure on a face cast, so I also measure the teeth over that to make sure they're not too big or too small. Then you wanna repeat this process until you have a crap ton. His chompers are a little jaggedy but pretty rectangular in shape, and I made them relatively flat so that they'll sit well in the gums we make and won't stick out too far. This is another tutorial where the reference images are gonna be your best friend at every single step. Also, I suggest making more than you think you will need. Speaking of gums, this is the first part of the face that we are making. As I said, I'm using a face cast, but you could build this on a mannequin head or any rounded head-sized surface. I'm making the base structure out of foil, and I build the top gums over my nose and upper lip area, and the bottom gums between my chin and bottom lip. I make sure not to cover my mouth, as this is one of those FX makeups where we're gonna have to be a mouth breather. I do apologize. Layer the foil until it is the shape you want, keeping in mind that we'll be adding latex paste and the teeth on top, so try not to make it too thick. And then once I have the structure of both gum pieces, I hold a couple of teeth up to check that I've left a good amount of space in between. Then I wanted to secure these to the face cast while I worked on them, so I used a little bit of liquid latex to stick them down. You'll see in a bit why this was an error on my part. So to build up the gums, I use latex paste as per usual. Simply a mix of liquid latex and flour, and I spread on a fairly even layer of that, keeping it confined to the foil area. I dipped my finger in plain liquid latex to smooth that base layer out, and after that it's time to start adding the teeth. I started with the middlemost two so that I could keep everything fairly symmetrical, and I press them in so that about half the tooth is resting in the latex paste. This way they will actually stick in there. Then repeat this for the rest of the teeth. Then you want to secure those in even further by creating a gum line around them. I put down a line of the latex paste along the top of the teeth, and then use plain latex again on a spatula to smooth and shape that around each tooth. Once again, a reference image is useful if you want to add smaller details. For example, I made the gums come down a little bit lower on the front two teeth. And then somehow I didn't record me finishing the top jaw, so I will show you on the lower one. As you can see, I did the bottom teeth in the exact same manner I just explained, and once you are at that stage, you want to create all the little dents in the gums. I used the spatula again to scoop out a line of the paste extending from the center of each two teeth, and then I dip my finger in plain latex and smooth out all those ridges. Then you can use that exact same process to make all these little divots and lumpy areas in random spots along each gum ridge. Fingers crossed you can just see what I mean and what I'm doing. And this is how that looks with all the detail complete, and how they will look once they have dried. To remove them, you can just jimmy in a palette knife or whatever you have under the foil. And this is where sticking it to the face cast bit me in the arse a bit, because the foil structure kind of pulled apart when I did this. However, because foil is very malleable, this is easily fixed by smushing the prosthetic pieces back into place on my face cast, so that once again they can conform to the shape of my face. Now we can begin to build the rest of Nemesis's face. I firstly use some air drying clay to map out where the gum prosthetics will need to fit under this part. The reason I make the two gums and the rest of the face separate pieces is so that I have a little more freedom to adjust things when I apply everything, and also a little more mobility in terms of being able to talk under the prosthetic and kind of move my mouth around. I also make sure to build up some clay over my actual mouth and the eye areas so that nothing will be stuck down to my lips or my mobile eyelids. I, for some reason, only put clay over the eye that will be on show, but I do add some to the other in a bit. You don't really want the prosthetic pressing down on either eyeball area. Once that's all built up, I start applying latex paste over the whole face cast, roughly shaping around the one open eye and around where the gum pieces will be. Here is where I realized that I should have put clay over both eyes, so I scraped off the paste, added some clay in that area, and covered it back up. Once you have that base layer down, you can start to smooth it all out with your finger dipped in plain latex, and from there you can add in the details of his face. The main feature I would say is the big stapled scar that extends over the covered eye and up the forehead. So I scoop out that area of paste and shape where the skin is kind of stitched together and pulled apart. This is a continuous process of shaping with a tool and smoothing with your finger, and images of what you're trying to make are going to be so important for getting the details in the face. I also add more latex paste in areas that need to be a bit more bulbous, so around the mouth and eye and any other skin flappy areas. I use the spatula again to create lines around the mouth that make him look like he's baring his teeth, and I also add creases and lines around the eyes. Please bear in mind that this took me a really long time, so just be patient and keep shaping the paste until you're happy with it. Then to make his little staples, I folded up a piece of foil, cut off a length, folded the end so that it resembles, you guessed it, a staple, and pushed that into the paste. Repeat that for each one, and here is how that was looking once I was happy with it. Kind of hard to see when the paste is wet, but I tend to think it looks a bit naff before it dries anyway. So leave it overnight before you decide you did a terrible job. While it dries, I decided to make the chubby shoulder piece that Nemesis has. The whole neck and shoulder area ends up being a little rough and ready. The main focus is on the face prosthetic here, and I just wanted to pull it all together for photo purposes. Were you to go full cosplay with this, you'd want to make the shoulder and neck pieces more of a complete structure than I have here. As you can see, I'm shaping this around a mannequin head for size reference. It kind of goes across his chest and curves over his shoulders. So I built this piece to sit on the very outer edge of my shoulders. You can obviously measure it on yourself as you go. I leave the ends open like this, as again, this is for photo and video purposes, but you can make it a complete loop if you wish to. The base of his tubing, or whatever it is sort of plasticky looking and black. So I wrap this entire thing in black electrical tape, other than the very ends that, again, won't be seen. Kind of reminds me of a ram's horn or something. Then you want to mix up a fresh little batch of latex paste and add in some red liquid makeup. I think here I use an OCC lip tar, but you can use whatever you've got. The tubing has a gnarly body tissue looking webbing over it in a reddish colour, so adding colour straight to the latex is an easy way to achieve that and saves you a really boring paint job. It will look like a light pink, but it does dry down much darker in colour, so then you just want to smear that on in a random holy fashion. I make sure to keep it very rough looking, not smoothing anything out with plain latex, and I took that all along the black tape, not worrying too much about any inner parts that won't be seen when we wear this. I also made a quick version of his flappy neck skin pieces. Again, if you're gonna go full cosplay, you want to take more time and structure for this part, but I figured this video was long enough. On a board, I used masking tape to map out some shapes that somewhat resembled his loose neck skin. I did a couple of pieces here and a couple on another board so that I had lots of options to choose from, and once I'd laid out the shape, I spread over a very thin layer of latex paste and smoothed it out with my finger. It was literally that simple, and you have passable saggy neck skin pieces. Leave those to dry and we can return to our fully set Nemesis face for the paint job. For the base colour, I used a pinky toned foundation over the whole prosthetic. Don't worry if you get it on the foil, it's very easily cleaned off. Then I used a dark brown cream paint in those stapled together gaps, all around the eye socket and the inside rim of the mouth. Here is where I realised I hadn't given Nemesis his very distinctive creepy eye scar, so I added in a line of latex paste from the bottom of the eye to the side of the mouth and a little above the eye. I made sure it was fairly thick so that it dried raised. Once that is dry, we can continue painting. I use more of that brown to define any creases we made in the latex paste and also to make that scar stand out. I put some around the side of each staple and blended some alongside each of the gaps in between to make the skin look raised. I then went in with a little black on the inside edges of those spaces and along the inside of the eye and mouth. Also a little bit along the staples to make them appear deeper in the skin. And then to make his skin look more mottled, I speckled some brown over the forehead and then blended it in with a little bit more of that initial foundation colour. Onto the gums. I paint a layer of a light, cool pink. You want to be careful around the teeth, the clay does pick up colour very easily and they're a bugger to clean off when they don't have a layer of varnish on. If you look at pictures, his gums are very purpley, so I'm defining all the little indentations that we made with a royal blue shade and then blending this out with a lighter purple to get the exact tone that I'm after. I do the same thing at the top of each tooth with a little more brown added to it, and then I use a mix of those blue and purple shades to colour the top and sides of the prosthetic. This is just going to give it more shadow and dimension when the face piece is applied over it. I also highlight the gum ridges with a bit more of that first pink colour, and then I colour the teeth with a very light wash of yellow, keeping the most concentration of this to the base of each tooth. Lastly, I add a little bit of white to further highlight the gums, and they should be looking something like this when you are finished. Painting the skin pieces is really, really simple, as is removing them from the board. All you need to do is find an edge and gently peel the whole thing up and cover both sides in a generous amount of loose powder to get rid of any stickiness. For colour, I did a base layer of the same pinkish foundation we used on the face piece, and then I randomly smudged on areas of brown cream paint and blended it with more foundation to give it that mottled feel. To seal all of that colour into place, I'm painting on a layer of craft glue, and I do the exact same thing for the gum pieces and the face prosthetic, just to make everything look really fleshy and gross. If you need to know how to remove this from the face cast, I do have a specific video for that. Here I am in my lovely bald cap. I already have it on because I am not the most adept at applying these, but there are a butt ton of videos on YouTube if you need to know how. Also, you need to make sure that you've covered your ears with the bald cap because a nemesis doesn't appear to have any. I hold everything up to ensure it's gonna sit correctly on my face, and then I start by applying the gum pieces. I put Prozade all over the area where the prosthetic will make contact with my skin for both the top and bottom piece. And while I wait for that to get sticky, I paint black all along my lip so that nothing will look out of place behind the teeth. Then you can pop the gums right on. It is always tricky putting things over my lip piercing. I really press those on to make sure they're making good contact with my skin and to take the weight off them while they adhere. Before applying the face piece, you want to paint the eye area that will be exposed with black, as we did with the mouth. I can honestly say that I have never looked better. I then apply Prozade to the back of the prosthetic on any areas that are going to make contact with my skin, avoiding the eye areas. Now is the time to coat your eyebrows in Vaseline so that they remain intact, unless you're like me and you forget. Once that is tacky, you can apply it, kind of stretching it across the gum pieces and making sure it's comfortable around the eyes. Really take your time pressing all the edges down and getting it as flush with your head as possible. If you get a face itch while you have this on, I pray for you. Then we are going to blend the edges of both the prosthetic and the bald cap with a few layers of liquid latex, and then we need to extend those staples along the top of our head. I lay down a decent amount of latex and then stick down two pieces of unrolled cotton ball side by side. I saturate these in more latex, keeping my head tilted forward so that none can drip near my precious eyeball. And then I use a spatula to continue that pulled together skin pattern, smoothing the edges onto my head as best as I can. I appreciate this is difficult to see when it's all white. Now is the time to add in more of those little foil staples, pressing them in the same way we did with the latex paste. And then whilst that all dries, I paint my neck with a brown watercolour paint so that it looks darker under our skin flappy pieces later on. And then I also swipe on some light pink to give it more of a muscular look. Then once the cotton and latex is dry, it will likely still be white. So I go over it with a more watered down mix of that brown colour, and this will massively help to blend it under the rest of the paint job. You probably guessed it, the first colour I use is that pinky foundation all over the bald cap as well as the cotton and latex area. Then we can continue that brown and black colouring into those stapled gaps, adding some along the puckered edges of the skin again and at the base of each staple. Then my absolute favourite part, I'm going to use a toothbrush and watercolour makeup to speckle on a bunch of different tones. I think I used brown, pink, grey and yellow, and the trick is to keep layering all the different colours all over the ball cap and the seam of the face piece, and it creates such a good blend in my opinion. Try to avoid the actual prosthetics that we've already painted. This again is a pretty long process, but I swear it's worth it. When you're finished, you can use a little water to wipe any speckles off of the staples. Now comes the neck and shoulder pieces, which I want to reiterate was purely for photo and video purposes. This wasn't really that practical to walk around in for very long. You need your tubing piece on, and I began by cutting out one of my skin pieces, and I stuck this around the very top of my neck so that the other pieces would have something to blend into. I then used this large piece and stuck that around the sides of my neck. All the tendrily pieces that hung down, I secured around the tubing with micropore tape because, again, this was purely for photos. Once that was done to every piece hanging down, I cut up another skin flap and attached a piece to the very back of my neck, doing this on both sides to make my shoulders look hencher, I guess. Once that was all on there the way I wanted, I added some more of that watercolour speckling to those skin pieces, just so that they match the tone of my head, and we are finally done! Days and days later. Hopefully you guys like this. I love Nemesis. He is absolutely terrifying, but I also kind of think he's maybe a softie. Really, really, really deep down. If you did enjoy it, I would love it if you subscribe to my channel. And feel free to give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment while you're down there. Check out my Patreon if you're interested in supporting me on there. And don't forget to follow my other social media, all of which will be linked down below and at the end of the video. Go have a look on bloodydisgusting.com if you need a further dose of all things horror. Thank you so, so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!